Good morning, Mr. Mohit. I am here for your training session, and I am the HR manager of Sunshine College. And as you have selected in 200 of employees, and you have given the induction and orientation in our campus, but this is the training session which will include the probational period of your job here. And here we will tell you about the some kind of trainings regarding the attendance sheet, how you take the attendance, how you have to declare the result, how you have to maintain the discipline and decorum of the college, and many more things. And also, as you have also experience of 2 years in some another college, I think that I do not have to put a lot of pressure on you regarding these things. So I think that we should start now.
Okay.
This is training session I have already shared. This is the logo of our college. And as you can see, the tagline of our college is that make your future bright with us. I have told the HR manager, I have told you that we have one of the leading colleges in the city, and we are having a great brilliant alumni here, as every 1 out of 10 student here which has passed out their degree or the post-graduation degree, they went to the top MNCs in throughout the world, and they get a job with maximum packages. And also one of our student also get the highest job package ever in any placement in Australia. And also this tagline improve the mentality of the people also regarding the image of the college, as they have feel that they have a trustworthy college in their city. So by this tagline, we have a grade of goodwill in the nearby neighborhood, and also this is making a good impression on people to give the students trust for them making their futures bright. As we have the faculty which has a very great knowledge, and also they have a great experience in this field, and also I also feel that you will also be one of the best associate in the college, as you have a very good highest qualifications, and also I have also seen your experience certificate, and it is very good character certificate they have given to us. So the next thing is that these are the templates which you may use in this period. These templates are the attendance sheet. In this sheet, you have to take the attendance of the students which are present in the class, and you have to take the attendance of every student in every lecture, and you have to mark the attendance of every student. And also if anyone is not present here in the class, then you have to mark on the absent side, and also you have to go at the end, you have to go to the message room, as we send the messages to every student's parent regarding their absence in the school. As by doing this, we make them aware that their board is not present at the school and at the college this time. As I mentioned the term school, the Sunshine College is not only the branch of colleges, but also we have schools in Melbourne and Sydney also. And this is a very great step taken by one of our innovative HR associate regarding the attendance sheet messages. As if anyone, as you know that teenagers are very bold and they want to try to learn new things, but if they get on the wrong track, then it's not only the parents' responsibility, but it is also our responsibility to take them on the right track. So by doing this, they also get afraid of not going to the mass bunk or to the bunk, because by doing this, they will get to know, their parents will get to know that their word is not present, and not in the school, college also, but also they are not attending their lectures. Because if anyone loses his or her lecture, then he or she may face low grades in the examination, which never any parent wants that their child is getting low grades in the examination. So the next thing is that the balance sheet of the college. This is the attendance sheet of the college here. You have to take, these are examples of the students, Tom Densley, Jim Smart examples. Now you have, this is the yearly attendance sheet. You have to manage the daily attendance sheet. After that, you have to calculate the daily attendance, and then you have to take the the final one output to the month wise, like Jan, Feb, March, April, May, and after that you have to calculate the whole numbers of a student at the end, and you have to write in this column, and after that you have to calculate the percentage. For this you have the calculator, and also you can use the computer to calculate the percentages, and it is very crucial step to count the attendance, as we have a provision of having 75% attendance to get in the examinations.
So sir, basically this is the standard attendance sheet used by the college.
Yes sir.
So I really like it that we have a standard template for that, and we have to work and give attendance to students according to the organizations. So this template is attendance sheet. Okay sir.
And also you can see that there is a logo of our college at the attendance sheet. You can also see the college logo at every template and also on every notice, because it is a very crucial, because it states that it is associated with our college, and also it is presented by it, because as you know that there are very teenage students are very naughty. They can leak any notice without our permission, and also they can claim anything. But they cannot copyright the college's logo, because if they don't have the college, to use the college logo, they have to take permission from the government also. But if they don't use this logo, everyone knows that it will be a fake one. So we have used the logo of our college at everyone, and also at your profile, you will also get a college logo, and also at your identity card. And make sure that if any notice from anyone, if you get it without the college's logo, then you make sure that it is not the authentic one, and you may file a case and also make the complaint to me or to the higher authorities.
Okay sir, I will take care of this.
Yes. As I have previously said, that this is the balance sheet of our college. Here you can see all the assets and liabilities of our college, because we think that we must be transparent to every person in this world, because being transparent is making them trustworthy on us and making them reliable on us. Because if they see that we have what kind of financial conditions we have, they want to get that we are providing a very good facilities to the students, and also the playground facilities, water tap facilities, the purified water facilities, and also the renovation is also held every 4 years. So for doing that, we must have a good financial position, and also as per the government policies, we all have to show the attendance sheet, but we made it public from start of our college, and also you can see here the logo also. As I have previously said, that this logo is very crucial one, and this is also the trademark and also patented to us, and I am giving you the copy of the templates. You can check that this balance sheet is the same as in the hard copy of the templates. And the next thing, this is the weekly task list. Here you have to write down the tasks here, what you are going to do on the Monday, on Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday and Saturday. You have to give the task description here. You will get this from our college, and every month basis you will get 4 of these sheets on every month, and you make sure that you must fill all these things on daily basis, because if you write on this, then you will get to remember this on every point, and also at the end of the day you will get to know that how much tasks are completed and also which tasks is not completed or in progress. The first thing you must do is the task description. You have to write what task is to do, and after that you must type the category of this thing. The term category is related to the completion, pending and in the progress state. And mainly this is done for the assignments of the students, because every teacher wants that his or her students make their assignments on time, and also to remind them, because some students are negligible and also unresponsible to their studies. After that you must write the due date of the task. As I have previously told you that the assignment is a very crucial one, and if we don't get the assignment of students, then we must have to fail them. And also, you after that, you put the status of that, the pending one, and after that the status that this is for the start of the week and this is for the end of the week. If the status is completed one, then you are sure that you have completed that task. But if it is still in the progress, then you must make sure that you have to do this as soon as possible. And after that, you must note the things, what difficulties you find, what risk is there, what kind of effectiveness was there, and any good things which you find out regarding that. And if any person is, as in the assignment case, is not presented their assignments till the due date, after reminding them by you, you make sure that his name and his roll number is noted here. And after that, you will get to the HOD and give him or her the name of the student and make sure to get in their mind that these children had not presented their assignments till the due date. Because it's now the HOD's work that they must get to the student, and also make sure to remind them that if they are not going to submit their assignment, then they are going to face some kind of difficulties. And you have to deal with them. And have to write that day, month and year of the week start date, that this list is for this week, and you have to make sure that you will make this on the Sundays and the previous Sunday. In the upcoming week, you have to do these tasks on Monday, on Tuesday, on Wednesday, on Thursday, on Friday, on Saturday. And now, this is the employee information form which we write down at the time of the induction and orientation. Here we have written down the personal details of employees and also the job information and as which designation is there of the employee and the emergency contact information. As I have told you that there are various kind of emergency situation, as if any employee get fainted and also get ill, then we must contact their parents or the emergency contacts, which one is presented there and whose number is presented here. And we have given the provino, full name, first name, middle name, and the address of the employee. Because we have the provision of the background check of every employee, and we have to do it very neat and clear, and also with on the legal basis. And you can see the logo at the top left corner of this, and I'm availing you of this again and again, because we know that the collegeites are very naughty and they also try to fool people, and sometimes they also try to fool the new employee. But make sure if there is no college logo, then you are sure that that is not issued by the college. And after that, the email, birth date, marital status, spouse name and the spouse, employee, and also the spouse work phone, as we have to figure out that his or her spouse is not have a criminal record, and also various things are ready for that. And the next thing is the examination result of your student. This is very crucial one, that how you are going to see the result of the student. First thing you have to do is have given the example of this. First of all, you have to give the name of the students, and after that you have to write down the numbers in the subject. This is just an example to show you. And if the thing you are handling on and how you are responsible to one, how many subjects. If you have the class teacher, then you have to make sure that you are going on an appropriate way. Then you have to write the numbers in the front of their subject of any person. Just example, Kim was get 49 marks in English, then you must write down the number here, and for the economics here, the risk management here, the business stats here, and the account marks here.
This is a basic result template that the college use to show the result to the student. So yes, we have to prepare according to the standards.
Yes, you have to make sure, because these are the standards set by the higher authorities regarding the style guide which we use. And it is very important to be on the style guide. We cannot make any significant difference to that, because they are out of standards and we may face some legal actions against that. And after that, you have to write minimum marks of which a person needs to obtain to get passed, and after that you have to write down the total percentage of the marks obtained by a student. So this is the examination result course which you must give at the presentation meeting to the students' parents and also to the guardians also. So make sure you must follow the standards and the procedures of this. And the next template which I am going to show you is, this is the letterhead. This is mainly used to give the letters and applications, just like the suspension form, the resignation, the appointment letter, and also for the application one. Every employee has to write any kind of application or letter on this regarding anything, and you must make sure that the letterhead contains the logo and the address of the college, and you have to write on the legal standards or to write the letter, and you have to follow that for using this, and you will get the letterheads on the 10 per month, but you can have a leave of only 1.5 days per month, because we are very crucial regarding the law, the studies of our students. So we make sure that every employee is presented at every day, but you know that there are a lot of mishappenings, and also everyone have emergencies and personal relation. So that's why we have fixed the time for 1.5 year or to make this, and you will get this letterheads when you are joining the company. Okay, so thank you, Mr. Mohit. This is your training session. As I have told you regarding templates and also the things which you must know about this, and you must follow the procedures. If you want to see the standards, I will show you in the next thing. So, thank you, Mr. Mohit.